Hello friends.
Hello everyone.
Very good evening from Team AW. As always, we are with you and the house is open for the question. Directly moving to the point, plagiarism of our discussion today. So, we are here with the obviously with Lokesh Adhikari. We welcome you all on this live webinar. Yeah, we are moving with the Vamsi Krishna question. How to without question? Sorry, I couldn't get your question. How to write without plagiarism?
How to write without?
Yeah, Vamsi. Writing without plagiarism means don't think about the plagiarism. First thing is write from your own thinking. If you see that I will not copy, why are you trying to copy? If you are going through the research and review, have your own perception. Be honest, as we have many times enchanted that you have to be honest. You have to be honest in writing. When you are taking the thing seriously, and just like God, you cannot cheat. If you are cheating, you are cheating yourself. So what you have to practice, that give due attribution to each and every source. Honestly, this is a simple key of avoiding plagiarism. In some cases, maybe some lines which you can't avoid, we have given the things like quoting and other things. And sometimes, like say for example, in regulatory bodies, definitions are there. You will have to take as such, no issue. I can understand that in this thing. So by practicing these things, you can write without any hitch, I think. But you will have to be very fluent in writing the sentences with cohesion and coherence. So,
Tom and Dick Harry conferences. Alok Ranjan is asking about Tom and Dick Harry conferences are worthless. Why did they happen?
Actually, these kind of things happen because some people, maybe like us or in our fraternity, give them the due weightage. Maybe. If you don't give them weightage, Alok, don't give the weightage. Don't disseminate those things. It is the simple key to avoid. There are always positive and negative things. You have to choose the thing. You choose the positive thing. If you are going to conferences, go to the quality conference in which you can gain. Don't waste your time and money in going to the conferences which are just meant for earning through the registration.
Which tool is best for plagiarism?
Very
important question.
Actually, I would like to tell you, the best may be unreachable for you. So, I don't think say which tool is the best. If you can get the things, get that particular resource in the as a genuine force, just go through that. Urkund, Authenticate, Turnitin, these are the most of the journals are using Authenticate and Turnitin. And the most widely used, I think, Lokesh, Authenticate?
Yes.
Yeah, Authenticate. I have got so many my manuscript with that Authenticate report. So Authenticate, if you can afford, Authenticate is the best with sense of the coverage.
Citations are also showed as plagiarized. Is that alright? We need to clear
this question. Yeah, of course. Citation, you know, many things are. Sometimes you will see that even your affiliation comes under the plagiarism. It doesn't mean. Everyone understands that if it is written that Dr. Rajesh MLT, Department of Pharmaceutical Sciences, HNP Gadwal Institute, it will show as a plagiarism.
Hello. Hello to everyone.
So, now you might be seeing the location. So, you can also ask, no issue. So, what I mean to say, everyone understand that reviewer. Because if I am a student, if I am submitting these, I cannot decide what to exclude from that report. Actually, this is the supervisor and the librarian in which to which, to whom you are submitting the things. So exclusion is on his or her discrimination power. If your article is there, it will be excluded. So don't worry about that thing. Even the references, obviously this will come, it will show it, but it doesn't matter, we will just have to exclude them. Okay?
There is one question. If we cured some petition from the previous one with due mention of authors, should it be counted as a person of plagiarism?
Yeah. If you are from your own?
Not from you, from some petition from previous work.
You can quote with due attribution, no issue. We have already mentioned in our text, I think,
so
3 lines, 39 words.
Whether it will be counted as a person of plagiarism, even if she is giving...
No, it is, you know, you can justify it to your supervisor and to your librarian. However, the machine tool will take it as a plagiarism. No, it will take. It will take. But if it is under quote, then you can claim that it should be excluded. Yeah.
Asking to look
at sir, is there any software which can detect the sentences? Because it is very hard to detect the plagiarism to rephrase sentences. Many of points taken. Sir, correct question they are taking, right? Webinar is not clear. Double voice? Achha, double voice, so sorry, I have to. Sorry, double voice is due to my my speaker was on. It will not be shown. Okay. Tony, the voice not be double now. Actually, I forget to mute my mobile phone. Will the data and statistics given in quotes are to be asked in exam? You know, data I'm not going to ask. You know, don't worry about the exams. You get the thing done. You learn the thing, the exam will be clear. No issue. No, I'm not going to ask any numerical. We are not going to ask any statistics. Don't worry about that. Not at all. Okay? How much plagiarism allowed in Urkund? No. Plagiarism allowed. If you say Urkund is no one to allow anything to any. Actually, in UGC, in Government of India, UGC has allowed actually plagiarism. You can't say that how much cheating is allowed.
Yes.
You can't say like this. Cheating is cheating. Whether you take one line, whether you take two lines, if you are not giving the due attribution, it is plagiarism.
And any software or tool does not decide the level of plagiarism allowed. Okay. The regulating agencies like UGC or any other academic agency or the publisher, they decide how much plagiarism is allowed in any type of literature. Okay, there is nothing to do with the tools or softwares available online, offline, whatever, with the limit of plagiarism allowed.
Pankaj Uprati, Pankaj is asking, can a single person buy Turnitin software?
No.
Turnitin, you can get Turnitin institutional. Turnitin gives only institutional subscription.
But Authenticate is another service from that service provider which you can buy for yourself. Authenticate is for individual user, Turnitin is for institutional user.
Humanshu is asking that some of the introductory part is always common in history, so how many references should be provided so that it is not considered as a plagiarism? You know, whatever the introduction is done, what you have to do, you have to give your voice, your own understanding, your own language. Okay? When you are starting the things, you will have to present, even if I am repeating my work on a particular topic, if I have written a particular research, I have done a work on the complex system of phospholipid complex system. So many papers I have published. So again and again, I have to revise my own work.
Yes.
Even.
Yes.
However, I could have taken the same thing from the same publisher, same author is same. I could have taken, but I have to.
That is not allowed, actually.
Actually, it is not allowed. Self-plagiarism is another thing. So we will have to again and again revise the sentences in such a way that it is original to you. Okay?
Aman Bhardwaj is asking, if plagiarism comes to notice after 10 years, is it valid? If there is any time.
Yes.
If someone has committed murder 20 years back, it's the same question. Okay, same answer. You can understand.
Aman Bhardwaj.
Aman?
Aman Bhardwaj.
How much percent plagiarism is allowed as per UGC for the PhD? It's 10%. More
yes.
than 10%, it should not be there. If Rahul was asking what are the punishments, we have given in the rather in the webinar first. We have given the link of that draft rule. No, not final rule by the plagiarism rules are there, in which the punishments are mentioned. In the severe punishment, the research scholar may lose, may be terminated from the PhD. I'm putting you the extreme cases only. Where there are the percent by thing, you will be given another chance. You will be denied the submission. You may be denied the submission in case of PhD. Teachers may lose their increments. May lose their supervisor, being supervisor, PhD supervisor, or sometimes may termination also.
Yes. One question is there, interesting question. Please answer my question that suppose someone's statement or some statement or fact is available in more than one article, should I give all the references for that statement or fact in thesis? In my opinion, you have to give the first, the reference of the first author who coined that idea or that philosophy. Okay, you don't have to cite all the references wherever you have read that line. You just have to cite the first author where the term, phenomena or the concept was coined. Okay.
Secondly, Alok is asking how can I avoid the image plagiarism. Rather, image plagiarism, okay. You cannot tone. Image plagiarism is to that for some fundamental things, if the image is in Creative Commons, if it is understood that, say for example, we have quoted a figure on the process of literature review, you will come to know that. We have taken that Creative Commons figure. You should take only that figure which is under the Creative Commons license. You can't take any figure which is in a particular copyright. Okay? So avoid those figures.
Yes.
If even if it is copyright, you can reframe it in your own way. Okay? So that's why you can image plagiarism, we have shown, ma'am might have told you the image plagiarism stem cell research. The same, the image was plagiarized there. Okay? Can a single person by turn, yeah, this we have answered, yeah. CS, as far as many questions are there regarding
yes,
the CS. Is there any career advancement scheme? Directly it is not
applicable.
You can't say that. It is not equivalent to the refresher course. You have to go to the RPIT courses for that. But I assure you, if you do this course, you won't be running after the APIs. Once you will get the projects, you will be able to get the projects. You complete this course, do this course, apply those things. You will not be asking for APIs and all that within 6 months or 8 months, I can assure you. So please, it's your choice.
One question is there. Being a PG teacher, I want to examine thesis of students. Can I use any software? As we have, in majority of the cases, we have only the 1000-word limitation in open source softwares or freely available sources, that you cannot use these softwares for the scrutiny of thesis. But you can purchase any of these services like Authenticate or any other service, and then you can use it for your examination of thesis of students.
Hi, Suman is telling that what if my work matches with other unknowingly? So it's very uncertain that you are
unintentional. You know, it is very uncommon that two people get the same idea. It
yes.
may be there for
exactly
a certain extent,
idea.
But it cannot be exactly copied. It
has,
is. And if it is plagiarism is detected by a machine, no? If machine says, machine is not biased. If it is say it is plagiarized, you will have to accept it. Even if it, you say that I have not taken from any other. If the work has been done already, it means that you will have to reframe the sentence. You cannot claim that you are the original generator of those terms.
Okay, image ka, there is one person asking how to
sir
know
answered.
That any image is copyright.
Sir,
answered. Image copyright
ka
bohu gaya. Image copyright. Image copyright कैसे है ऐसा?
How will we know that image is copyright?
देखिए, until unless Creative Commons license is there,
written, yes,
is written.
Everything
there,
is in copyright.
In create, you go to the Office 365. If you have the that version, the purchase version,
yes.
you will find online pictures. You will click on that online pictures. you will get the that thing. If Lokesh can show you,
screen.
Lokesh will show you the screen. That how we can take. You take a PPT. I had the pleasure Office 365 genuine version, purchase version. So, however, you can search the Creative Commons image even from the Google. No issue. You will have to go to the advanced search and then in the filters you will get the Creative Commons license. I'm letting you know.
Pankaj Subredi is asking in later, is it possible that this course will run under the Arpit scheme, which may be benefited for teachers for their promotion?
We cannot be sure about that, but
it may be. It is.
Yes.
It may be.
We are positive about that.
We are positive in the positive note.
Yes.
Regarding this. Okay. How to type the quote of the same author that we might be using in our location? Meanwhile, you can show them.
Yes, I'm trying.
Meanwhile, Lokesh is trying to
methodology. There is one question, and I think two or three person has asked the same question. Vamuchi Krishna also asked that the methodology is same when you are referring to any research paper, or if you are following any research paper and the methodology is same, whether it but you have to cite that reference.
It happens. Especially in the sciences, I become sometimes very frustrated. What happens? That a certain set of procedure is common. The language is common. That you are running a set of experiment. That certain lines are whatever they will be. They are going to be same. But again, you have to write in this some different way. Otherwise, or you can take it up to the that 10% limit. It should be you try that. You keep it in the section, that section, methodology section, because if you are copying each and every word, even the same process, same thing, I have to rewrite in my own words, in some different words again and again, though the methodology is standard thing same. I told you that machine, it is software, it will detect it as a plagiarism.
Aman Bhardwaj is again asking, are the online plagiarism free softwares are trustworthy or not? Sir, provide the name of some trustworthy softwares.
Of plagiarism.
We cannot be sure about the trust issue, or every software which is working in that field is working on the basis of the available database. The coverage of database may change from the one software to another, but there are no trust issues in that case. Okay, no one will give you a false report, as I see or as I know about this concept.
Actually, it is for you just how to understand the things, that whether my work is copied or not. I will give you the simple reason. You put whatever you have written, if you have written the 20 lines maybe, you put those 10 lines or 20 lines into the Google search bar. Simple thing. You will get the things that it has been copied from anywhere else. However, percentage you will not put, you will come to know that it has been copied from exactly or not.
Yes.
Simple way. Actually, it is for just self-awareness. Otherwise, it is not your domain to check the plagiarism. It is the domain of supervisor, it is the domain of librarian, to which the work, or to the domain of editor, which the team which is evaluating your work. So you will have to be honest, and you just check on the thing with the help of some software if you need. Because for last 16 years, for the very first time, I got the opportunity to have the Urkut access just before the course itself, so we could show you how. Otherwise, I was not having any plagiarism software for that. Yeah.
One question was asked that which one is the best software for plagiarism check? Which one is available to you with the full database access? That one is the best. If I have access to Urkut, then Urkut is best for me because it is available for me. Then in that case, Turnitin is not the best because I have to go somewhere else to use that service, or I have to borrow from my friend the credentials, and or I have to send my files to them.
And so, that too, it is available only for faculty members,
yes,
not for students.
Yes.
If institute provides this ID, this is only available for the faculty members. Only students can just send the mail their content. And the teacher's ID will be used for evaluating teacher, and the faculty member can only use that.
Okay.
Remember this.
This was the answer on the basis of the availability. If we see this thing in the technical way, technically Turnitin has the largest database And that's why it has the best coverage and it gives the highest results in case of plagiarism report, or best report I can say. And additionally, it also gives you a grammatical report or grammatical analysis of your database, of your document, on the basis of their wide database. Okay, then Turnitin is the best option if you can afford it, or Authenticate if you can afford it, or Turnitin if it is available to you.
No, Anand was saying that I would like to, again, I think we are re-answering this thing, that when we write paper reviewer, check it on plagiarism, even citation also consider as plagiarism. You know, they use the harsh words. What is the solution for it, you are saying? Actually, the references, if it happens sometimes, if that series of references are the same as used in the previous paper, no, then it is objectionable. Means the same, some author has used reference number one, that the same reference which you have used, the reference number two, the same reference which you have used. So it may be objectionable. So always remember, if you are quoting, if you are using cross reference, don't use them in a same pattern. You will be caught, because it is again a kind of what was that matter? Look at jismein wo that matching, jismein mosaic, or iski baat kar raha tha,
fingerprinting
caught you, yes. Can catch you, yes. Very simple.
Paraphrasing is also a plagiarism. Pathan Mujahid Khan, he has asked to
Pathan ji, paraphrasing is it's a disease as well as the drug itself, okay? Paraphrasing is also a kind of plagiarism, and paraphrasing also a tool for avoiding plagiarism. It depends how you use it. If you are just, you are paraphrasing the things, just shuffling the words and not using the reference, you have used the paraphrasing partially, then it is plagiarism. If you have reshuffled things, use your own words, use your own voice, and attributed that reference, then you have avoided the plagiarism. This is a simple difference.
A very simple but important question is there. Are the references comes under plagiarism? No, sir. They did not. And don't worry about the references. They don't
generally the references, when we submit papers, standard practice is not to include references into the that plagiarism check.
Someone has asked that he or she converts the text into the table form, whether it will be counted as
that's okay, that you can do it. Review writing, you do it like that. Sometimes many articles are having tables of more than 5 pages or 7 pages. Then you can condense them. It is your way of presentation, you are presenting the thing. Then you will not be the case of plagiarism.
One question is there. In my research paper, if 60% content is from other sources, but I have given credit to all the sources, is that plagiarism? Yes, it is, because the limit is 30% at maximum and 10% at minimum. UGC says that you can only write 10% of others' content. It does not, it has nothing to do with the citation or referencing. You cannot write 60% of someone other's paper and after citing all the sources, you cannot say that it is a new paper. There is nothing new in that. Okay?
So, Munish is saying the percentage limit of direct quotation in an article. Munish, ye depend karta hai ki aap kis subject pe baat kar rahe ho. If you are referring to a subject of Hindi, in which I am referring to the quotes of Tulsidas, in English quotes of Shakespeare, I am doing the PhD on the Shakespeare, and I will have to quote the lines again and again, no issue. So there will not be the limit. But in a standard research paper, theses have different scenario. In the standard research paper, the things will be, even the quote can't be used, I think 3 lines, 39 words, in a stretch. However, they can be used, but this limit should be less than 10%. And maximum, I think, if a particular article, in general, most of the publishers have the policy that if a research article or review article is having plagiarism or similarity more than 15%, they outrightly reject in the one shot itself before sending to the review itself. They don't send the article to the review even if it is more than 15 to 20% plagiarized.
Difference between citation and references.
Citation and references APA, ML, CMS, big three we have said. Is citations, work cited, references, they are the bibliographies.
Yes.
In the different, same thing are there. Depending on the writing style, we give them the names. Doesn't matter. Just, referencing means we are citing someone's work. It is citation is a, can say, is a phenomena through which we are referring to those.
Going to do that. Hmm? Yes.
If you are paraphrasing, giving due credit to the author also, it will be counted as a plagiarism.
No. Is the data taken from one source can be plagiarism? Yes. If it is not yours, then it can be. And data, image, anything that comes under the literature or any type of data, plagiarism if it is not yours and fresh. Okay?
So if you are doing paraphrasing and giving due credit to the author, it is not plagiarism.
Do we cite a journal which has cited the article and intro discussion, or should we cite the original article which has come to that conclusion? While citing references, it happens, Dhruvji, Dhruv Kapoor. While citing references, do we cite a journal which has cited that article in intro discussion? You know, you should try to have the original source for the very first time. Because it may be problem for you if you are using the secondary source. Try to have the primary source. Sometimes what happens that the source which is shown by your, even the plagiarism software, is not the original one actually. What happens in the pharmaceutical sciences, many sources, say for example, that plagiarism report says that it has been from the slide share, this. Okay. The slide share people have taken it from the pharmacopoeia, that the our authentic books, official books of pharmacy, like in the constitution, they say. If the lines are from constitution and it has been taken in the slide share, sometimes it says, because constitution may not be completely online, that part. Okay. I'm not a law person, constitution, baby, but what I will say, it will just show you the immediately available version only. You will have to ensure whether it is the original source or not. Okay?
How many lines we can quote in our text? Only 10%. Not more than that. Overall consideration, which is allowed in any type of literature, is 10% by UGC. If you are going to write it for any Indian publisher or UGC, you have to stick with the 10%.
How can I cite from lecture or any speech? Actually, citation is done in general only for the published versions, basically. However, you should cite. Even I used to cite.
Nowadays, we can cite from videos if they are available online.
Yeah, of course. You
have to cite whatever can be traceable. You have to cite it.
You will have. Say for example, if whatever we are discussing here,
yes,
it may not be written, but it is there in the version.
Yes.
Okay. So you can just put that webinar 3,
yes,
academic,
yes,
writing, and then YouTube,
yes,
code,
link.
That YouTube link you can give. Okay. In the same way, I used to give the quote, even when I was in 2009, I was in University of Hyderabad. I used to quote the 9 characters of Guru in most of the lectures when I'm talking with the faculty in the faculty development program. That 9 character guru of Professor Rao told us, actually he quoted a Sanskrit shloka. So I always quote him that he told me on that particular day, in that particular way, with my slide. So this is the kind of reference. Okay? It is not written anywhere, but it is my honesty that I give him the due credit. Okay?
Karvanan S. I copied many words and cited using Mendeley. Online plagiarism shows 0% plagiarism. Is that right? That could be right in case that you are using a tool with a limited database. Okay. If you try to scan that file or check plagiarism or get plagiarism report from any other software, maybe you will get a more precise report related to your work. Okay.
Can we show them all that figure? Yes, yes. Ashish is asking what should we write at the end. This is a very important question. For bibliography, ideally it should be references, not the bibliography. Bibliography is a common practice, you know. If I was reading Andromeda Strain by the Michael Crichton. Okay, very nice bibliography. You know, when the Michael Crichton, you might be knowing, authors of the Steven Spielberg's most of the movies, you know, the novel based movies of Michael Crichton. So Michael Crichton is a kind of author who referred lot many things, but he can't refer the things. When he talking about a biological a doctor, he writes as if he himself is a doctor. So the bibliography may be okay for the novels and all that, but it is not okay for your thesis, but not okay for your research papers and review papers. Okay. It may also be for the okay for the books. For if you are writing books, bibliography may be okay. Okay, but not for paper, research paper review. The Guru Prasad, I have published a review article in conference. Shall I extend my study on the same topic and publish it in a UGC gazette? Of course, I have published a review article in a conference. But if you have published a review article in a conference and you are already showing it as a conference proceeding, it is going to be the repetition. If you are not showing it already in your workshop, and if it is in just a form of, you have presented it just orally, then obviously you can publish it in any peer listed or approved journal. Okay? Will any exam center in Rajkot for doctorate exam? Most probably will have. Okay? Yeah. We'll be discussing this thing in September, most probably. Okay?
Manila Bhatia is asking, for thesis submission, which chapter is checked for plagiarism issue? Your whole thesis will be checked.
Nothing is left. I think except that preface
references,
and acknowledgement.
References and content.
Okay. And references. In later stage, is it possible to quote the papers? Okay. Can I believe only free plagiarism in figure come under plagiarism? Another thing, open software. Open software, we have told you, please pursue. I would like to add you, meanwhile, please locate, go for the fresh questions also.
Yes.
We are going to come up with a subjective assignment soon, most probably in this week itself. What you have to do, you have to write 800 to 1000 words, not more, not less than 800, not more than 1000. Remember that thing. Original, don't write abstract. Forget about that. You just write a 800 to 1000 short article, words article, give this title, your name, affiliation, and just start writing. Be unique, be and write in a subject relevant thing. Okay?
Clarity.
With clarity, reader friendliness,
yes.
Whatever the traits we have discussed. Okay? The cohesion, the coherence, put those things, and then you will have to load that article into the link which we will be giving along with its plagiarism report, same articles plagiarism which you have written through the proposio. Okay?
Pre-postio.
You just go through that link which will be there again.
Yes.
It's a free software which, and but why we are limiting to 1000 words? Because that software does not
only
take
allows,
more than 1000 words.
Only allows for 1000 words.
Okay. Yes. So by this way, you will come to know how to write effectively, what then should be focused, and that these, it will be evaluated for your internal mark. It is a graded assignment to be there. Because in this course, total two subjective assignments will be there. I don't want to go for homework like thing, which is just like table of two or table of three. But I want to be result oriented so that you can learn the thing. Okay. Meanwhile, we will be taking more questions.
Yes. What about the bibliometric review paper? Is it the compilation of information from various sources? Then why it doesn't come under plagiarism? Bibliometric.
Pardon?
Bibliometric reviews. Bibliometric review paper. Why it does not come under plagiarism?
going to meta-analysis sort of.
Yes.
No, it comes. Actually, even if you are compiling the reviews or bibliometric reviews, you are not supposed to copy the things. Even if it is written there, you cannot re-quote it. Now, what is the advantage of doing the bibliometric review? You will have to give your own voice. Again, I am saying the same thing. You will have to present it in a unique way which may provide or which may give light or new domain to that particular field. And this is the purpose. So don't go for the repetition of the thing. It is futile.
In case of module development and its effectiveness, will module be checked for plagiarism? This is a very interesting question. Yes, every module you are getting in this course is already checked for plagiarism. Okay, and everyone, every course available on the Swayam platform has to go with this process.
Of course, and that too, even if it is there, you might not be knowing that particular source, but we know that this is our own source, from where we taken, and it is under Creative Commons license.
Yes.
Okay, so we have ensured the thing, and that too, until and unless we are giving the commercial advantage of that thing, until unless we are taking it, because it is open for all, it is open for everyone. If you are selling the things for the profit, that matter is very serious. You might be seeing the many things which you know very well. The people have written the blogs and all the things. They have kept it open until it is the things are public. Until else you are claiming, you are not claiming. The things are open. But we have ensured the plagiarism below 10% in each and every module. You can check it out. And sometimes I was surprised when it was 0% and 2% in the very single shot. Because we have, most of the time we have been extempore in talking rather than we recorded the video and then wrote this script.
Okay, Abhay Pratap is asking.
Yes, ma'am.
Checking.
Yes, it is
paper,
very interesting question.
Checking paper again and again, plagiarism software, our content saved in
digitally.
So, is it right way to check only one time?
In most of the cases, every software, every tool which allows you to get a similarity report also gives you a command on that if you can share your data with their database or not. If you are going to share your data with their database or not. Okay, so do one thing. Whenever you upload your script or your literature to any type of these services, just click on that. Do not include your literature on their database. So that problem will be solved. You can scan your literature again and again. Okay.
Nimish, but congratulations, you caught us, because I was just trying. I included that exercise in this week itself. I was checking it whether it is working nicely or not. And if you have already submitted that article, kudos to you. Okay. But I will also add this thing that you can submit multiple. You can multiple submissions are again allowed here. Only the last entry will be taken for the evaluation, and that too after the last date only the assignment will be evaluated. Okay. So take your time. Don't be in hurry. Even if you are writing the 800,000 words, sit calmly. Sit with your full mind, full concentration. Okay.
I think there is a confusion between the open licensing and plagiarism. Because many of you have asked about if we are using Wikipedia or any other open source, and then it will come under plagiarism or not. I think we have to understand two different things here, two different phenomena. One is open licensing like CC by SA or any other type of open licensing and copyright. And another thing is the plagiarism. Any content with the CC license is not allowed to write in just as it is in your literature. And it will come under the plagiarism. It will come under plagiarism. Whether it is copyrighted data or open license data.
Creative Commons will also come under the plagiarism.
Yes,
but
yes,
don't forget
yes,
about it.
Yes.
But
don't be confused.
Whenever the person will say that what is the source and what is the type of source, so you will have to write in the references that it is Creative Commons license reference.
And the benefit with CC license is only that you don't have to take permission from that person, or you don't have to pay for that literature or any anything, any information, any type of information you are getting from that source. You don't have to pay for that in case of CC licenses.
See, Manisha is asking, can this course can be used for credit transfer for PhD coursework? So what
it can be used, and, but it depends on the committee members if
and
they
syllabus.
Use it in the BOS.
In syllabus also.
Input it in the syllabus of that 3 PhD. So you can introduce this course to your university, your institute as a course, because many universities are going to come up with this course as their core paper in their 3 PhD, especially some of the universities, then the credit transfer will be there. Okay. And
do international journals also follow the same range, 10-30% of citation reference
limitation?
Are
very strict.
Yes.
The, more than 15% they don't take.
Yes.
Okay. If subject is same or title is same, what we do, sorry sir, subject may be same, okay, but title may not be, can't be same exactly. Even if you are planning the same title, you should avoid the title which has already been published, okay, with that same title.
Is any free plagiarism checker available? We have discussed this already in the third lecture, third module.
Go through the
modules.
It is discussed there.
Yes, it has already been discussed.
Rather, as far as the styles are concerned, like Vancouver style, all that, what I insist that, that styles are not important. Only whatever the journal is letting you know is important. Sometimes I don't remember that in which style I am writing. I just go by the author's instructions. So, go by that.
Can we check from 2-3 free online available plagiarism check? Yes, of course you can check, but your plagiarism report may be different based on the plagiarism detection tool which you are using and what are their databases. So your report may vary, but of course you can check it.
Yes. Projects cleared the plagiarism are meaningless. Students of MBA preparing projects in such a way that the software clears their work, but when seen during the Viva exam, not found any stuff. Okay. I think now in present time the document may get 0% of similarity, but there are cases after 10 years or 5 years or 6 years someone got caught for plagiarism and get punished for that. So there is
one more thing, tricky things that avoiding the plagiarism, it may cost the service of that library.
Yes.
Oh, because
yes,
he or she has done something wrong. Okay. The teacher, the supervisor may lose his or her job. So it is, if you are a faculty member, it is your responsibility to aware this the plagiarism, to disseminate the awareness about the plagiarism in your students, because it may affect not only your career but also their career. So both will be affected.
Okay, Shivgami is asking, does quoting definition from Wikipedia or Investopedia amount to
plagiarism? Yes, but that question I have already answered, that you have to think and understand there are two different principles are being applied here. One is licensing by CCNSA and another is about plagiarism. Okay, Wikipedia or Investopedia, these websites have content with CC license, which explains that you don't have to take permission from the author. You can just cite the author and use their information or the content, but you have to go through the content, rewrite it in your own way or in your own words, and then it will be plagiarism free. So yes, the content from Wikipedia or Investopedia, it can increase the amount of plagiarism in your document if you use is as it is.
The conference paper can be submitted to the journal?
Yes,
if
they are not published.
According to the biometric standard rules,
if they are not published.
If that, it should not be published in full article
proceedings
form.
Or proceeding of conference.
It should not be there,
yes,
published in,
yes,
in full article form. Even it should not be published in the web.
Yes.
Okay.
Internet.
If it is online, journey, it should not be published. But I should say tips ki baat bhaiya ye hai ki you will have to be honest. Sabse badi baat to hai aapko honest rehna padega agar aapko avoid karna hai plagiarism. You will have to write in your own sentences, own words. Theek hai?
टेक्स्ट को वर्ड में कन्वर्ट कीजिए, वर्ड को टेक्स्ट में कीजिए अगर आप लिटरेचर रिव्यू लिख रहे हैं. इफ यू आर राइटिंग लिटरेचर रिव्यू ट्राई टू शफल दैट फ्रॉम टेक्स्ट टू वर्ड्स एंड वर्ड टू टेक्स्ट एंड राइट इन योर ओन वर्ड्स एंड ट्राई टू बी सिंपल इन प्रेजेंटेशन. इफ यू विल गिव दिस सिंपल प्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द कॉम्प्लेक्स पेपर यू विल बी रेड मोर, यूर रीडिंग विल बी मोर. एंड गिव डू एट्रीब्यूशन, इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. And thirdly, I would like to add that whenever you are quoting the things, give due attribution, each and every quote. Yes.
If text taken from Vedas or ancient book is plagiarized?
No. Unless you claim that you have written them. Okay, because it is not the property of anyone. If I say, if I quote Gita Shloka, okay, obviously I am quoting Gita. No particular person, no one has the copyright.
There are two types of laws which applies here. One is Copyright Act and another is Plagiarism Act. Copyright Act is because someone may have copyrighted that material and then you cannot use it without his permission. And another, plagiarism, you cannot copy anyone's text if it is available anywhere from a valid source.
Ashika is saying if I use my swan quote notes for my class lecture, will that come under plagiarism? No.
Unless you are going to publish it.
If you use it for fair uses, even the copyright allows that copyright material can also be used for the teaching and learning.
Yes.
Okay. But if you distribute the copies, you take the money for them, you commercialize the thing by your name, then you are in problem. Okay. Otherwise not. It is free to use. But don't forget to attribute even when you are disseminating it for the teaching and learning. Your students have the full right to know the source of the information. Okay.
One question is there, is images taken from Google also plagiarized? If yes, how we have to take permission to whom?
लिखा है चाहे नहीं लिखा, whether it is written there or not, it is copyright. You take it granted, you don't take it granted that okay, copyright नहीं लिखा है बोले तो चलेगा, नहीं, वो copyright कहीं ना कहीं है. Okay, so you will have to ensure until this Creative Commons is there, license there, you are taking from Wikipedia, no issue. You give, even then, we have shown the reference of Wikipedia.
Yes.
Even when we are quoting from the Wikipedia, that pages, you will have to attribute even for the Creative Commons.
For that you, in Google, you go in advanced setting and then you search the images which are free to use and share.
Yes.
This I have already mentioned in my.
Yes, yes.
And we'll be discussing in the literature review again in the soon.
One interesting question is there, sir. Mm-hmm. Suppose I accidentally happen to know about the plagiarism done by my colleague and happens to be my co-author. How do I proceed?
It happened with me. Because being in co-author, being in a. Corresponding author,
yes.
You have the equal responsibility. You
yes.
have the credit. You have the discredit, both. Okay.
When your name is there, you have responsibility.
You will have to. That's why we say that don't use the authorship as a gift.
Greasing.
Yeah. Yes. For greasing, don't use it because it is double-edged sword.
Yes.
You will get the credit. You will also get the discredit. One of the professors, I won't name him. He's in a very good position at that time. He copied entire article of my 2009 article in 2012. I came to know that it is there. Just drug was removed there, drug was replaced, everything was ditto. Okay?
Even data
so,
was
there. Even data was there, even figure was there, even table was there, ditto copied were there. Then I wrote him a mail, respected sir, I happened to copy your article in 2009, which has been published in 2000, your article has been published in 2012. Okay, so sorry. I would like to let you know that I have done it in the different drug. So he was astonished. Then you can't imagine what he did. He apologized. Sent a apology letter to me, sent a apology. He said that no, my student has done. Doesn't matter at all. He is the corresponding author.
Yes.
He is the author there. But why the supervisors are there? Why the mentors are there? if their students had done something wrong, they will have to take the responsibility. And what happened? They will have, that fellow had to retract that article from the, retract means removal. Someone also asked, they were, even after publishing, Indians and in the South India Pacific area, most retractions have been done in Springer and elsewhere. This is the data. Indian and Chinese authors. जो पब्लिश हो भी गया वो भी वापस हो जाता है, साथ में रेड में लिखा रहता है रिट्रैक्टेड, मींस यू हैव कॉपीड इट, इट इज जस्ट लाइक हैविंग ए समन ऑन योर समन, नहीं उससे भी आगे का चीज हो, यू आर ऑलरेडी पनिश्ड फॉर दैट.
अप टू हाउ मेनी इयर्स आफ्टर पब्लिशिंग द थीसिस द डेटा कैन बी यूज्ड फॉर एकेडमिक राइटिंग एज पब्लिकेशन इन जनरल अंटिल अनलेस इट इज रिलेवेंट.
You can publish it,
yes,
at for any time. And you can publish, yes, your work. No issue.
And you cannot use your research data, your thesis data for your research paper. It will come under self-plagiarism. No. Someone has asked that whether I can use my thesis data for writing a research paper.
Of course, thesis writing, thesis work out, yes, of the thesis they can use.
Yes.
They can use.
That's why the rule is there, na? We have to write some number of papers, few number of papers.
Until unless उसने पहले paper नहीं छपा रखा.
Yes, it is already not available on the.
Yeah, you can't say that you have पहले उसका आपने research article बनाया, उसका thesis बनाया, वापस से करेंगे नहीं. No, you can't take double advantage from the single source.
One question is there: how to, whom to, and where to report about the plagiarism? The authority which published the data. Just
first you report to the
authority or publisher, whoever it is.
Rahul, जहाँ भी आप submit कर रहे हैं,
yes,
wherever you are going to submit. अगर आप research paper submit कर रहे हैं, if you are submitting the research paper to the editor, editor will take care of this thing. It is not the part of the writer. It is the part of reviewer, editor, or the librarian.
I think he is asking about someone other's paper. He found that paper is plagiarized.
हाँ, then you can claim.
Yes.
वो जहाँ छपा है.
Yes, you have to write a letter for publisher.
वो आपको ये भी लगता है कि वो जो है वो ये संभव ही नहीं है ऐसा करना, पॉसिबल नहीं, यू कैन आस्क,
यस
यू कैन आस्क द थिंग
आस्क फॉर फर्दर डेटा और फुल डेटा और एक्सप्लेनेशन व्हाटएवर.
देवाशीष इज आस्किंग,
देवाशीष, विल इट बी प्लैगरिज्म टू फॉर्म ए मेडिसिन ऑफ हर्ब हुज इफेक्ट इज ऑलरेडी मेंशनड? नो, ऐसा है देवाशीष, बट प्लैगरिज्म मेडिसिन का जो है जाहिर सी बात है वो इनोवेशन तो है ही नहीं, तो वो प्लैगरिज्म होगा. That plagiarism will be there. तो अगर आप उसी चीज को कहोगे ये पहले से effective, वो plagiarism तो है.
Yes.
और वो सरासर जो already known है, उसको कोई मतलब नहीं है उसको बताने का. That it is not rational. वो rationality नहीं है उसके अंदर. मैं ये नहीं कह सकता कि नीम की जो है हल्दी जो है वो होता है. ठीक है. So we would like to wrap up the things with some common queries. Yeah.
We will be answering now common queries and those.
प्लैगरिज्म का एक जो एक अगर एक लाइन में उसे ख़त्म करना हो तो के सिर्फ अंदाजे बयां बात बदल देता है, वरना दुनिया में कोई बात नई बात नहीं. हर चीज़ जो लिखी गई है वो कहीं ना कहीं अवेलेबल है, बट आपको अपना अंदाजे बयां देखने की ज़रूरत है कि आप किस तरीके से उस बात को रखते हैं. बस
तो हैव योर ओन व्यूज.
यस,
प्लैगरिज्म इज इन्फॉर्म टू द ऑथर इफ पेपर क्लियर द प्लैगरिज्म टेस्ट इज दैट आल्सो इन्फॉर्म. या ऑफ कोर्स प्लैगरिज्म क्लियर करता है तो तब तो आपको नहीं इन्फॉर्म किया जाएगा, वो आगे प्रोसेस हो जाएगा. इफ इट विल बी प्रोसेस फर्दर, इफ इट इज रिजेक्ट यू विल बी रिपोर्टेड दैट. ओके, वी हैव टू बी, वी हैव टू पी एस इन आवर स्टेट ओनली. आई कांट से दिस डे
दे नो, शी इज टेलिंग कि समवन हैज डन द स्टडी इन हिज स्टेट एंड आई एम डूइंग द स्टडी इन माय स्टेट, विल इट बी प्लैगरिज्म?
सेम टॉपिक प्लेजरिज्म होगा भाई. कई लोग अगर दो लोग साथ में भी कर रहे हैं तो
देयर वुड बी वेरियस एंगल्स टू डू दैट पर्टिकुलर स्टडी आल्सो. यू कैन चूज अ डिफरेंट एंगल टू सी दैट प्रॉब्लम और अ डिफरेंट सॉल्यूशन. यू कैन सर्च फॉर अ डिफरेंट सॉल्यूशन,
बी यूनिक,
दैट्स नॉट अ प्रॉब्लम.
फ्री सॉफ्टवेयर यू कम टू नो, आपको मॉड्यूल में लिखा है.
इट डिपेंड्स वेदर यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द आईडिया और द ओल्ड डेटा और द कांसेप्ट दैट वी डोंट नो इन व्हिच कॉन्टेक्स्ट यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट. यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द आईडिया. You cannot take anybody's idea. That will be.
Idea is an intellectual property, Baba. Please remember. वो idea अगर मेरा idea भी है, मैं अगर Facebook पे लाके Creative Commons का license लगा दूँ, उसके बाद उस idea पे कोई patent की बात करता है, तो वो patent नहीं करा सकता था, क्योंकि वो idea मेरा Creative Commons license में है, मैंने रख रखा. अगर मैंने कह दिया non-commercial, non-derivative, तो उसका patent भी file नहीं कर सकता. Simple, मैंने Facebook पे Creative Commons के साथ वो अपना idea लगा दिया. Pradhan sir and all dear, I would like to recall the things that 9th of November is the examination date. Examination ke form aayenge.
references and bibliographic हम बात कर चुके हैं, table and figures.
Okay, please pay attention. We are going to answer the common queries of all. The very first query is the most widely used plagiarism detection tool. So the very widely used plagiarism detection tool is, it depends, Eternity, Orkut, Authenticate.
And most of the international journals use Authenticate,
yes,
as we felt.
Or cross-reference or Eternity.
I'm not going to give you the individual subscription. So many people have asked that Eternity gives a single use subscription. Will not give you.
So free software we have discussed in the module.
Okay, yes. And free softwares, everything I have discussed in the module. Please go through from the module. And the exam will be on 9th of November, and you will be informed
in the September 3rd.
You will be informed, yes. Everything. So don't worry about the exam. Please don't worry about the exam. You will be informed each and everything. Just check your emails regularly. And there was one more common question, references and bibliography. We have discussed the difference in the references and bibliography.
Okay, plagiarism is allowed again and again, people are asking, 10 to 15% is the limit.
Yes.
It's your standard limit of 10 to 15%, so you don't have to go.
Okay, Wikipedia, you can use Wikipedia material. Wikipedia, the definitions from Wikipedia and whether they are plagiarism, they are asking. So,
yes, they come under plagiarism.
Spell tool, we have given the spelling. We have given in the module. Please.
No. Please spell the tool name of plagiarism. Checking for plagiarism.
Okay, one.
Pre-post SEO like.
We have mentioned in the module. Please go through the module. Okay.
And one text. Has asked, yes, about how to write review and research papers. So we are coming up with these modules that how to write review,
yes,
research. And thesis, I think, of course, we are going to come up in 11th week and be discussing with you how to write thesis. So we have entire week devoted to this topic. So
and in the coming week, we are going to discuss your targeting problem, targeting a journal with respect to the journal metrics, impact factor and all that, and then author metrics. So coming week will be devoted to the journal metrics. We will be discussing what are impact factor, how we can target it.
Okay, the previous modules, those who have registered, even today, yesterday, you can access all the modules. It's there. It will be there in your dashboard. Please check your dashboard after logging into your account. Please, everything is there. And
announcement. Don't forget the announcement. Okay.
And one more thing. Enrollments are open still in this course till 31st of August this month. So I also request you to recommend and share about this course so that we can have more and more learners.
So friends, I think we have crossed 1 hour today. Thank you, and thanks to the NKN lab, especially Lalit ji is with us.
And those learners whose questions are not answered, please do come in discussion forum. We have
even you can ask a question again. We will try to answer it in this chat also.
Yes. Yes.
And even those learners, don't worry about that. My question is not answered. Don't worry. Come in discussion forum. You will get your answer. There is no problem because we, I think, we have bahut sare questions chhod diye hain.
One more thing. We have one Facebook page. We have one Google group. And one YouTube page. Okay. YouTube channel, Google group, and Facebook page. Whatever suits you, ask your queries. Any one of these three platforms, we will try to answer. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, dear. And happy learning. Lalit ji. So, Lalit sir, I will introduce Lalit.
Yes.
We can't organize this kind of webinar without the support of Lalit ji. Lalit ji is our in charge of NKN lab.
Yes.
We are very thankful to Lalit ji for this facility of NKN lab. Thank you, and thanks from the our course Academy Writing. So see you next time. Please go through the